Did you know that Siemens BW500 can be set up on an Ethernet IP network? First, be sure that your BW500 is configured to show rate, load, speed, and totals. Assuming that you are somewhat familiar with the Siemens BW500 and Allen Bradley configuration software, using Ethernet IP is straightforward. Ensure that the BW500 has an Ethernet IP SmartLinks card installed. If it doesn't, first power down the BW500, loosen the 6 screws, and open the lid. Insert the card into the BW500 SmartLinks port. Push the card onto the 34-pin connector and secure the card with the 2 supplied screws. Set all the dip switches on the card to the off position. Using a standard Ethernet cable, plug in one end into the SmartLinks card and the other into your laptop's Ethernet port. At this point, you could connect the BW500 directly to your local area network, but for this example, we will set up the network settings locally. Power up the BW500 and check that the LEDs on the SmartLinks card are illuminated or flashing. This confirms that the board was installed correctly. Close the lid of the BW500 and tighten the 6 screws. Next, we need to configure the network settings for the Ethernet IP SmartLinks card. For this, we are going to use IP config. This can be downloaded from the Siemens Service and Support website. After downloading IP config, simply run the installer to set up the IP config tool. Once installed, run the IP config tool to configure the network settings for the Ethernet IP SmartLinks card. Notice that the SmartLinks card has appeared with an IP address of 0.0.0.0. This is your new device. Double-click on the device to open the network settings window. Enter the desired network settings for your application. For this example, we are going to use IP address 192.168.0.50, gateway 192.168.0.1. Once you have entered the values, click on Set. Click on the Scan button in the main window to see the new settings. Your Ethernet IP SmartLinks card is now set up and ready to use. Open RS Logix 5000, then go to the File Open. Navigate to the location on your PC where you can save the sample project. Open the sample project and navigate to I/O Configuration and BW500. Click on the BW500. Enter the same IP address that you have entered in the IP Configuration tool. Set the input to 34 words and the output to 19 words, and then click OK. Download the configuration to your PLC. With the PLC in run, navigate to the main program folder, Program Tags. View the process values coming back from the BW500. Compare the process values to the BW500 display to confirm that everything is working correctly. Many processes will require the BW500 totalizers to be reset via communications. Ensure P799 on the BW500 is set to 1 for remote communications enabled. You can do this by pushing the PAR button on the BW500 2 times until the display shows View/Edit parameter. Enter 799 from the keypad of the BW500 and push the Enter key. If the value of P799 does not equal 1 for remote, then push the Enter key on the BW500 keypad to change the character on the display in the top right-hand corner from a V to an E. Enter 1, then push the Enter key. Push the Run key to put the BW500 back in the Run mode. In the Program Tags window, set reset_T1 to 1 to clear the totalizer. Read the total 1 from the Program Tags list to ensure the value has reset. To reset Totalizer 2, simply set reset_T2 to 1 to clear the totalizer. This concludes setting up the Siemens BW500 using an Ethernet IP network.